Aquele sonho de aprender inglês, de ver os pounds entrar no bolso, ganhar muito dinheiro, viver na Europa, loiras, mulheres bonitas, aventura, somente aventura.
It is difficult. How could we be English? How make ourselves more English?
I don't know. The stereotypical English person is very cold, not very warm, keeps to themselves, not very friendly, very suspicious
of
people.
But we are not new. We are not new. We do it.
Yeah, exactly. We make an effort.
London's weather, any cloud and rain should clear to leave a clear night with frost, lows in town of 2 Celsius.
Now, the English also...
Inglês é a pessoa mais engraçada que eu já vi até hoje. Apesar de eu não ter nenhum amigo inglês, conheço muitos, mas nunca saí com inglês para um pub, tomar uma cerveja, ficar conversando horas e horas. É realmente um cidadão totalmente diferente do latino, nós latinos.
But certainly when I was a child, the colonials, and the class system made you feel very much in an area of your own. You didn't branch outside that area, you just stayed in your own set. And we grew up with each other, you know, and we didn't really venture very far outside those families. And then when we went off to university, that's when we started branching out and meeting other people. But I mean, I think about 10 years, we went to the same place in the summer holidays and we'd meet up with the same set of friends.
Brixton is like a small village where everyone seems to know each other, like a friendly community. And the largest population of people here is people from the West Indies, mainly from Jamaica. So I do walk around, kind of like get the flavor of Jamaica, kind of like embedded in this small kind of like village, as I said, Brixton. You've got many different shops and like music is like a main priority for Brixton.
Racism in England is very covert. People hide it. They don't tell you to your face that they hate you because you're black. They will make million and one different excuses why you can't do something, but they will never say it's because you're black.
Oi,
When you're young, it's all about expectations. Your parents want you to succeed, so you go to school. You get an education. You meet boys. Life takes a new turn. But when you get to my age, people expect different things. You're expected to be married. Why aren't you married? Why haven't you got children? Why haven't you got a gorgeous husband? People only see you for who you are on the outside and what you look like. And because I have black skin, people will look at me and they will judge me because of the colour of my skin. And they create a perception of who I am. Some people aren't tolerant, some people are tolerant. Hey, I'm not conventional. I've never been described as conventional. Reliable, practical, sensible, even sexy, but never conventional.
Okay, let's check, there's no police of that. The bad side is that, unfortunately, like in other part of the world, there's some drugs coming in, heavy drugs like crack, cocaine, and this and that. And that's the bad side of Brixton. Good, non-police. Okay, so I could talk.
Esse sonho aqui, eu sei que eu não vou realizar isso nunca. Talvez é mais fácil ir pro Brasil trabalhar lá do que aqui. Se eu junto $1,000 aqui, eu gasto numa semana. Talvez o sacrifício de ficar 2 meses trabalhando pelos aqueles $1,000, em uma semana eu gasto ele pra soltar aquele espírito que ficou dentro. Pô, o cara me xingou tantas vezes que eu guardei esse dinheiro. Eu acho Londres uma cidade maravilhosa, é muito bonito, realmente. O primeiro impacto que eu tive foi vendo o Big Ben, tudo. Realmente muito bonito. Mas, como se diz, é chato chegar a um objetivo no instante. Eu fiquei muito decepcionado. As experiências dos lugares que eu morei, pensões, morei em casa que tinha 50 no quartinho, se exagerando, 10 no quartinho. E trabalho realmente não é pesado. A pressão das pessoas, sabendo que a gente é um latino-americano, há uma pressão muito grande, como se fosse uma discriminação, entende? Os caras chegam em você, what are you fucking doing? What are you fucking doing, bastard?
Okay, I guess probably to some of Brixton, I'll say it's something like Brazil, I would say. You know, it may be a poor community, but the people like get together and like they share on what they have, you know, and like they may not have a lot, but what they have got, they share.
I love long and strong, and I don't take easily to change. But girls, I have a solution. Always keep one of these. My new boyfriend, the hot water bottle. It's warm, cuddly and soft, and it doesn't answer you back and give you stress. Anyway. Yes, I was the only black face in my class. My sister, I mean, there were other black children in the school, but very few. You could count them on one hand or two hands. My sister experienced a lot of racism when she was there because she was older than me. I mean, it was difficult for my mother and my father, purely because my mum married a black man in the 60s. I've just come back from New York and realised there's more to life than a 9-to-5 job. Shopping is the new thing. I got myself a new credit card, especially for the occasion. It was all very exciting. I'm not a compulsive shopper, but I could become one. I realise I am a material girl. I never used to be, but then again, I suppose I'm a late developer. Who knows?
No início dos anos 60, eram comuns os cartazes com os dizeres fora negros, fora cachorros, fora irlandeses.
Unfortunately, Brixton is on a change at the moment. At the moment now, it's like a lot of money is being pumped into Brixton. and like the community is like breaking down because like working classes, business people are being moved in, and like the people who've been living there for quite a long time has been like pushed away out of Brixton. So now Brixton is kind of like getting very trendy.
Eu quero ir embora daqui o mais rápido possível, cara. O mais rápido possível.
Now, what does the future hold? I don't know. I was tempted to go and see a psychic, but I'm very scared of what they may recommend. I know I need change, but I'm frightened of the prospect of failing. I mean, life's a bitch, and you either become one or you die. I don't want to become a bitch, but then again, I don't want to die either. What's the solution?
Have a stiff upper lip and do not and mind everybody else's, mind your own business and don't get involved with anybody else. That's the motto.
Thank you.